Hello everybody, I am from Shet Vidya Mandir English High School and Junior College. My name is Ashalata Dandyal. Today I am going to teach 4th Standard Value Education Subject Lesson Number 4, The Clever Frog. It had rained the previous night. The air was cool and fresh in the forest. A group of frogs hopped through the thick bushes. They had never felt so happy and were enjoying themselves. Suddenly, one of senior frogs thought of starting a race. Let's see who hops the fastest and reaches the other end of the woods, he said. Soon, all the frogs hopped and hopped, each one trying to outrace the others. While some of them were energetic for a long time, others got tired and lagged behind. A few others picked up speed and leapt into the air on seeing the energetic frogs. Two young frogs led the group for a long time. No one was able to match their speed. They were very ahead of the others. One of the frogs in the group soon observed that these two frogs were nowhere to be seen. Concerned and worried, the whole group of frogs started out on a wild search. By and by, these frogs found that the two young frogs who led the race had fallen into a deep pit by accident. The pit had been covered with dry leaves and twigs and thus had not been visible. The two frogs, in their enthusiasm to be the first to finish the race, had fallen headlong into the pit. All the frogs in the group came hopping as fast as they could and gathered around the pit to see if they could help their friends. The pit was too deep and there was no way anyone could go in. All the frogs felt that it was a hopeless situation. Senior frog, who had initially suggested about the race, felt bad and told the two young frogs in the pit that they had no choice but to prepare themselves to face their end. The two frogs in the pit were quite shocked and began to jump up and down frantically. The frogs who stood outside shouted into the pit that it was all over and suggested that they should give up once that was their destiny. But the two frogs continued jumping as hard as they could and after several hours became tired, desperate and helpless. Finally, one of the frogs felt tired and discouraged. He became hopeless and quietly lay down at the bottom of the pit and died a while later. The frogs were grief-stricken. Meanwhile, the other frog continued to jump with every bit of energy he had. Although his body was paining and he felt giddy, seeing his desperate attempts, his friends felt bad and began to shout and scream for him to accept his fate. However, the tired frog jumped harder and harder and finally leapt so high that he sprang out of the pit. The other frogs were stunned. They all gathered around him and asked, "How come you kept jumping even though we told you that it was of no use?" The dazed frog carefully read the lips of his friends and slowly revealed to them that he was deaf. He said that when he saw their gestures and heard them shouting, he thought that they were cheering him up. That inspired him to try harder and he finally succeeded. Thus, even though he had misunderstood them, the optimistic frog was able to save himself and escape out of the pit. Values covered: encouragement, positive thinking, self-motivation. Thank you for watching this video.